simply a certain style of conversation. You need to focus on more on the client and the transformation they want to see. That's how you stand out. You're not just saying, you're like, it's a promise you know you can fulfill. Like, of course, it's that combination of in-house treatments, home care, lifestyle changes, that holistic approach. So we all sound the same. Therapists, salespeople, if you work at a beauty counter, people have their guard up because they're anticipating. We all sound the same. You have to stand out to get better clients, quality clients, clients that you gel with. So what can you give them that not the average therapist can give them? So you need to be different. And how do I mean different? A different approach, a different mindset. Say something that's not generic, like home care advice. Oh, drink water, stuff they can like Google at home, or stuff they've heard before. Like, how many times have you heard from like personal trainer, fitness, like, just diet and exercise, calories in, calories out. If it was that simple, it would be working. And there's clearly a lot more involved, especially with women, hormones, metabolism rate, lots of things. Yes, you want to simplify it, but it's a very straightforward, like, it's not really taking in people's emotions or the holistic approach. So to increase your sales, have a more holistic approach. And what is it with sales? What's that mindset that's going to click, that's going to get them to think differently? So they go from one dermatologist or one beauty therapist, skin expert, to the next, and they're getting the same advice over and over again. What makes you stand out? You have to focus on the change that the person wants. What type of change do they want? What transformation? I call it the vision. What vision do they want? Instead of focusing on their problems, like poor skin, poor shoulders, like, you focus on the, what would they like to see? How would you like your skin to look on your wedding day? How would you like your skin to look at the special occasion? How would you like your posture to be after our treatment sessions? How would you like? So I'm going to go into that in further detail now. But first, a quick reintroduction. If you're new here, I'm Kira. I do content all about the spa industry, beauty world, holistics and health and well-being. I try to promote spa treatments, and I'm a real advocate for therapists learning how to sell, because it benefits the client. It's a win-win situation. It's an extension of the treatment. It is how you give more value and how customers are going to get more value as well. So if you're on either end of the spectrum, like me, I used to be a therapist many years ago. I did reflexology, I did spa treatments, medi spa, salon, lots of different avenues, and try to open up my own clinic as well. So I've lots of views on that, and I've also lots of advice because I'm now stay at home mom and can give the perspective of a customer. And I just love the spa industry, and I wish it was more accessible, more affordable, for like to go more often. I wish it was literally like the setup I would love to see, like gyms, like a gym membership. You go a couple of times a week, 3-4 times a week. I'd love to see spas end up like that as well, because then I think people would just benefit from all, like, hot stone, Indian head massage, all these kind of different sauna, steam, something really, really regular. I know you can get sauna, steam, jacuzzis, that kind of thing in a gym, but I'd love to see it in more treatments focused. There's such an energy exchange when you get like a Reiki treatment, or just people to be more adventurous and try. So that's why I like to promote sales. It is a very professional skill to have. It's great as a therapist. I have so many videos about how it's going to make your career last longer. It's going to make you stand out. And that's why today I wanted to say, when you're selling, when you're talking to a client, having that conversation and recommending home care and products, because that's all sales is, simply a certain style of conversation. You need to focus on more on the client and the transformation they want to see. It's all about the transformation. And don't have generic things, like don't sound, the way you make your sales stand out is if you personalize it. Make it about the client. All your focus, all your questions is about their concern. It's not about you showing how much product knowledge you have. You should just be seen as the expert just by the setup of your shop environment, your sales environment, as I call it, by your, like, your professionalism comes from your sales environment and then how you show up, like literally how you greet them and your first impression, like physical appearance, grooming standards, that kind of thing, and your tone of voice. That says you're an expert. You don't need to like demonstrate, or your skill set when you're doing the treatment demonstrates that you're the expert as well, but not product knowledge and not telling them all the scientific details of a skincare product. You need to focus, ideally, or this is how I kind of tried to approach my sales and how I went from no sales. Literally, I couldn't sell. I just wasn't a natural. I had to break it down in my mind and kind of study books, do courses. I had like in-house training, but that was only for like a short day or two. It wasn't, then we had to go out and practice. So it's all about the practice. And then I topped it up with like my own type of sales training and other manuals. So I gathered information from all different industries and from these, like, there's a book, Frank Bettinger or Tony Robbins, I read as well. Lots of Dale Carnegie, I think. These are some of the masters in it regarding sales. There's a man called Miss Miner. I'll have to get the name for him, or Myron Grant is very good sales as well. There's some gurus out there anyway, but they're all very masculine, or they're all not focused on like the spa industry. Sometimes you need a specific example. This is how you talk to the client. So today's video is about reminding you, try this out in your next sales session. Talk more about the transformation the client wants to experience. Not so much their problems, but more talk about what change your treatment or your treatment upgrade or your rebooking, as in getting them to come back in or getting cross promotion, like try, suggest a different type of treatment. Like they came in and they booked a hot stone massage, but you know that their attention is particularly in their like trapezius and their neck muscles. So this person really needs an Indian head. They really need like Indian head massage, which is like, or acupuncture or pressure points, like all a pressure point massage on the scalp. That's where their tension is, or craniosacral therapy. They might need a chiropractor if you've experience with that, that you can cross promote, and that's a form of sales as well. But to focus and ask the client about the transformation, the change they want to see. That's how you stand out. You're not just saying, you're like, it's a promise you know you can fulfill. Like, yes, you will definitely feel difference with this style of hot stone. We use hot stone in the clinic all the time. It is one stroke of hot stone is equivalent to 10 manual effleurage opening massage strokes. So can you see the benefit, like that, the straight away? This is going to transform your posture. This is going to get you to where you want to be. You have a sports event coming up, or you know, make it about the client. So you have to get that consultation right, get to their main concern, their main concern, but don't focus on the problem. Like, I find that really negative type of selling. Like, oh, I see here that you have sun damage on your skin. I see here that you have this kind of tension in your muscles. Sometimes that kind of scares clients or wakes them up a bit, but I just don't think in the greater scheme of things that that is the most ethical approach. I think the more ethical approach is demonstrating a transformation that they could experience, and you knowing 100% you've seen this before, this is the correct treatment. You're the matchmaker between the client and the correct treatment, the client and the correct problem for their, the correct product for their problem that's going to give them the solution. So be solution focused and have better home care advice. That just don't be generic. I think you'll sound generic if you're rattling off something you learned in the product manual, something you learned off a beauty ad. Everybody hears this now. You see all the eye creams are hyaluronic acid or this or that. Say things like it's going to lift your eye area, it's going to plump out the skin, it's going to give you nourishment, hydration, but like, make it about the transformation the client has. Does the client have a special occasion? Do you even know that? So make it like, don't sell them a generic eye cream like you're selling to the masses. Sell specifically to them. You mentioned you have a big work presentation coming up. You're in for a skincare treatment today. The treatment you chose was a hydration booster facial. Perfect choice before an event, because it's not going to cause, like, it's not a peel or something abrasive like microdermabrasion, like that may cause breakout to clear out the skin, which is a good thing, which you want proper results. But when, don't take the chance when you're doing like a special occasion is coming up so closely. You literally want luminous, glowing from within skin. Is that true? Yeah, for your presentation you want to feel confident. Get the client's agreement. What is the transformation you want for them? And don't underestimate the power of skin treatments and products in somebody's like confidence levels and why they need them. If you've seen the effects and you've used the products yourself, then you know you're going to be a good salesperson. So it's your whole mindset, your whole approach. So focus on, after this facial, your skin will look like this. I've seen it on many clients. Or make it about, you mentioned this event, or you mentioned this concern, you mentioned, like, talk about a treatment plan that's specific to them. Or kindly, if you have to point out, like, there's a lot of oil, does that concern you? You talk about wanting better skin texture and you want your makeup to sit better, but I don't think you see the link between exfoliation and how saturated your T-zone oily area is. So you can say it nicely instead of being like, I see sun damage on your skin, I see this, or any of those generic rattling. Don't sound the same. Really don't sound the same. I think advanced skincare skills is like that, being able to interact. All that product, all that background information is for you, the therapist, to know. It makes you confident in your products or in your treatment, because you use them on yourself and you see the results on clients as well. So a lot of that is, you need to now become the artist and play around with being able to adapt. I keep saying matchmaker because it really is, in the treatment you have to match and make it all about the client. So talk about the transformation, the positive results. Don't sound generic, and you won't sound generic if you personalize the treatment. Don't sound like every other salesperson, because that makes somebody's guard go up. So all this comes with practice. Somebody's guard goes up because nobody wants to be sold to, or that feeling of it's not ethical. If you make it personalized to them, It's just a conversation. You'll create really good rapport, as they call it. Rapport is just like good relationship with the client. I have so many videos about how to talk to the client. But if you guys have a specific problem, I want to help you. I am giving free sales consultations. So you can DM me on, like, write a message to me. If you want specific advice for your situation, if you want me to give you an actual script of what to say, if you want me to give you a checklist of these are the things I need to have said, or these are the things to make the sale happen, like just a step-by-step process if you prefer that, or a lot of my videos focus on the mindset, because I also have content about queen mindset, which is all self-development, and I can talk to you via email if you prefer as well, or we can set up an actual face-to-face Zoom call. Let me know in the comments below and I will get in touch. I'm going to offer a sales mentor program, but I need some feedback because I want to do a sales course for you guys as well. Something self-directed that you guys can follow in your own time. If that's helpful, give me a thumbs up on this video, then I'll know, okay, they like this content. They actually do need a written course or like a video course. Tell me what you prefer. I know therapists tend to like more visual or demonstrative learning. Do you agree? Hopefully this was helpful. Try it out. Have that nugget of like, okay, transformation. Focus on what, not just what results I can get them, the transformation. How will the client feel at the end of my treatment or the treatment course I'm suggesting? And don't forget that the treatment course is that combination of in-house treatments, home care, lifestyle changes, that holistic approach, that overall, they can't just rely on your one treatment to walk out and you to be the magician and look like you're a beautician, not a magician, as they say. It needs to be, that's not how the body works. The body works in conjunction with other factors like lifestyle, health, nutrition, mood, people's spiritual health as well. Like, you can't be in this industry and ignore all that. You see so many examples of how, like, somebody's going through a stressful time, or how, like, they're getting certain medication and treatment and how it affects them, their overall health. And it shows in the body. It shows if you look hard enough. So that's my holistic views on treatments and helping others. So I will see you guys in the next video. Let me know if there's a specific topic you want me to cover. And I hope this mindset of personalizing and focusing on the transformation you'll get for the client will really help you in your next sales approach with your client. Keep practicing. Let me know how you're getting on. See you in the comments below. Thank you.